How's it going, guys? My name is Jimmy Champagne, and today we're going to be talking about something a little different from Halloween, and that's thanks to the fact that Amazon Studios dropped the trailer for their remake of Dario Argento's seminal masterpiece, Suspiria. Now, I am really excited for this movie, so I thought it'd be fun to kind of review the trailer and speculate on what we might be seeing when it releases later this fall. I actually saw the original Suspiria for the first time when I covered it on my podcast, Fear Frequency, and despite that fact, I think it is a total masterpiece, and it's as close to perfect as you can get with a horror movie. The three big things I liked most about it were the way it was filmed, the use of color, and of course, the perfect soundtrack by Goblin. Now that being said, unlike a lot of other people out there, I'm totally fine with the fact that Amazon Studios and Luca Guadagnino set out to remake this movie because it's very clear, as they've been saying for months and I guess even years that this has been in the works, this is a totally different movie than the original, and it seems much more like a modern reimagining that's working with the themes of the original rather than a shot-for-shot remake, which is exactly what I wanted. The first thing I absolutely love about this trailer is that it spoils virtually nothing other than the basic plot setup of the movie. Now you can say that, yeah, it's just a 2.5 minute trailer, so how hard is it really not to spoil anything? But as we've seen over what feels like just the past few years, you can spoil a lot more about a movie in way less than 2.5 minutes. The basic plot of this movie is that there's a prestigious dance school in Berlin, Germany called the Marcos Academy, and it's led by Tilda Swinton's character, Madame Blanc. Now, Madame Blanc tells her students that when you perform another artist's dance, you're also creating yourself in their image, which is obviously a big plot point that's going to play into this movie, because it turns out that the leaders of this school are ancient witches who are drawing power from the dancers, and they also have the ability to influence the world around them. One specific shot that stood out to me in terms of displaying this theme is the one of Madame Blanc with her hand on her dance student's back. Presumably, the dancers should be drawing power from her or whoever created the dance that they're performing, but you can clearly see that Madame Blanc is drawing power from the dancer she's making physical contact with. Speaking of Madame Blanc, one of the big changes from the original Suspiria I notice is that all three of the mothers from Dario Argento's Three Mothers trilogy will appear in this movie, at least in name. Before, they were individually featured in Suspiria, Inferno, and Mother of Tears, but the fact that they all show up in this movie makes me think that if Suspiria does well, we could be getting more remakes of Dario Argento's movies down the line. Another thing I've noticed is that while we've gotten a couple posters that show us a little bit of blood and gore, the two trailers for this movie have shown us almost virtually none of it. That sort of worried me because one of the shots that's been ingrained in my memory since I watched the original Suspiria is the image of a human chest opened up and the person's beating heart being stabbed with a knife. After a quick Google search and reading that at CinemaCon people were actually running out of the theater due to the gore they saw, I think it's obvious here that Amazon and Luca Guadagnino are just trying to hide the gore until we're actually in the theater watching the movie, so we can all see it fresh for the first time, and I am totally okay with that. Another big rumor coming out of this trailer is that Dr. Joseph Klemperer, who's credited as being played by Lutz Ebersdorf on IMDb, is actually Tilda Swinton covered in prosthetics. And since the character has a slightly feminine voice a couple times in the trailer and doesn't look anything like the actor who's credited as him, I'm inclined to believe that rumor. There's also the fact that Amazon owns IMDb, so if they wanted to trick us and fudge it a little bit on the website, this would be the movie to do it. This would also make sense to me because throughout the trailer we can see that Dakota Johnson's character Susie Bannon has a strength that threatens Madame Blanc. There are multiple shots of Madame Blanc leering at Susie in the trailer, and the way she's presented makes her look whole and unbroken at multiple points compared to Chloe Grace Moretz's Patricia Hingle. So if Madame Blanc wants to do some investigations into Susie and who she is without being noticed, taking the form of an old doctor just makes sense. It also looks like some of the people who are attending this school weren't exactly brought there on good terms and may have even been kidnapped, so by taking the form of an old doctor, Tilda Swinton can make sure the authorities stay off her trail. Madame Blanc is clearly a witch, and all of the students are extremely afraid of her, so they're not going to tell her anything, but by dressing up as an old doctor who's kind of non-threatening and unassuming, that's an easy way for Madame Blanc to get the dirt on all of the students at her school, especially Susie. I was not only impressed with the sheer amount of shots in this 2.5 minute trailer, but also the fact that all of them are pretty damn amazing, so of course I couldn't pick just one favorite, so I picked three. The first is the shot of what I'd presume to be Madame Blanc's coven. I love the 70s vibe of it and the contrast of the piercing red of her dress. The second shot I really like is this one of a dancer with one foot, and finally, I need to know more about this black burned monster washed in red because the design of it is amazing. I said it at the beginning of the video and I'll say it again now, that was a pretty damn awesome trailer, and because I don't want to spoil the entire movie for myself like I almost did with Halloween, I'm just giving you guys my surface level thoughts after watching it a couple times and and doing just a little bit of research. I am so excited for this movie, and I'm even more excited that it's coming out on October 26th here in LA instead of after Halloween, because this feels like an awesome movie to see around Halloween. If you want to see more trailer reviews like this one, let me know down in the comments below. And if you're not, it would really help me out if you subscribed. Anyways, guys, my name is Jimmy Champagne, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.